She said from the onset, oh, I want to have family. I want to have 8 kids, she said. 8 kids. Ukrainian girl saying, I want 8 kids. She was young.
The top 7 things you do not want to do with your new beautiful Ukrainian wife when you get her back home, or you will most likely fuck it up. I'm sitting today with the guy that you truly want to listen to, and you'll understand why in a moment. Hello, Jeff.
Hi, how you doing?
So thanks for being so brave and ratcheting up the cojones to share in a raw and real way with everybody here today.
Yeah, I'm glad to be here, thank you.
So let me ask you straight up, why should guys listen to you?
Well, I fucked up 2 marriages, does that count?
Yeah, that counts, Yeah, so, I mean, you were married twice to a beautiful Slavic wife, one
yes.
Moldovan, one Ukrainian, yeah?
Correct, yes.
You brought him back home, and it didn't work out, and today you're going to share why you believe the top 7 reasons why it didn't work.
Yes.
Okay. And from a perspective of what you did to contribute to the fuck-up, not what she did, right?
Yeah, nothing here about blame, because that's too easy to do, just project everything. It's her fault, she's this, she's that. This is purely self-reflective, hey, if I would have done these things, things would have been smoother and maybe the relationship would have had a chance. Not saying that, that it's guaranteed, but it certainly have a much better chance than making these critical mistakes for sure.
And again, not saying that she was a perfect angel by
not.
Any means,
no.
But from the perspective of what could you have done better? And most importantly, guys, we just want you to know that if you're going to have a go at this, it ain't easy, and you really got to get yourself a good, solid education, right?
Yeah, I wish I would have had these tips.
So let's dive right into this baby and talk about the top number 1 mistake that you think you made that you could have done better.
You really have to take your time to understand her needs, to be patient of the cultural differences. They are tremendous, and even if she's English-speaking, you don't realize until you get her to your environment how hard it is. So you have to be very acute to listen more. I know for me, I like to talk a lot, so sometimes you can over-talk. And I screwed that up. So
yeah. You know, Jeff, I can chime in there that I completely concur with you. Like, I was married to a Russian lady for 10 years. My situation was a little bit different. I met her in Canada, but still, her English was basic. So I still had to be cognizant and supportive on her acclimation into the country, into the language, the culture. And it was a bit of a steep learning curve, so I can relate to you.
Well, and it's our tendency to get back in our environment, and everything is just natural for us. And we forget very simple things are not normal for their culture, not normal for what she's used to. And when we get back into our routine, we forget about that. And that's really hard to focus on.
Absolutely. Like now that we've been living in Ukraine, you for 7 years, me for 3, we can really appreciate how hard it is to just
A classic example would be here in Ukraine, and they say, oh, just go over there and or take the bus and go there. Well, how? You don't speak Russian. You don't read the language, the cards. Well, it's the same as us taking them there and say, oh, just go to the store and go do that. And they're like, how?
So, Jeff, what would be point number 2, how you, contributed to fucking up your marriage?
Well, great question. You don't want to take your woman and look at her as like a woman proper, like my new maid, my new chef. Woohoo, I can now sit back and relax and enjoy my beer. You're putting a lot of pressure on her. First of all, it's not even her home country. How does she prepare? Every style and method of food, and the equipment that she's used to using in Ukraine doesn't exist in America, so or Canada or where you're from. That poses a monumental challenge, even if you're a good cook. And so to just take her into your new environment and say, okay, start cooking me meals, blah, 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 like you were, like what's happening when I was in village, that's too much to put on her.
It's a great point. I mean, don't take her for granted, right? And especially, she's going to really need most of her time learning English and acclimating to the culture in the country, right?
Yeah, and she might want to cook a meal for you, of course, but let it kind of be her decision. Like, well, would you mind if I cook you some dinner tonight?
Yeah.
And volunteer to help. again, it's going to be new stuff, new stove, new oven. I remember for me, my wife tried to cook stuff in the oven. Well, it's Fahrenheit instead of Celsius. It's electric, and she was used to gas. And so things were getting ruined, and it really, really upset her a lot. And it's to be expected, I think. Really, it is.
Jeff, what would be your third mistake or caution to guys when you get her back home?
Don't raise the bar too quickly. This is so easy to screw up.
Oh, my God.
We want to show off, hey, I'm from America, and you know I do this for a job, and I can provide you this great life. And your tendency is to, as what? Show how much you have. Show what you can do. And you start pushing the barrier by always buying, spending. You're kind of...
Ka-ching! Yeah. Rack up that credit card, baby.
And even if you don't intend to take the approach of buying her love, that's really what you're doing. And if you set that established from the very beginning, what are you going to do when you get back home? You're going to keep going higher and higher and higher. You'll spin yourself into oblivion. Or when you try to ratchet it back, she doesn't take that very well. Then she don't understand because you set those trends from the beginning.
Yeah, I completely agree. It's a huge mistake that I am definitely guilty of big time. I mean, because once the bar goes up and that standard of living goes up, it's very easy up and very sticky or going difficult down.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah. And if you try lowering it, they perceive it as you don't care about me anymore. Oh, why? We used to vacation twice or three times a year. In our case, we used to be every quarter, you know, 2 weeks every quarter. And then, you know, if times get a little bit more difficult and you need to ratchet back on the spending, yeah, it's difficult.
One of the biggest mistakes I think I really made looking back is that before I came, I wanted to make great surprise for her when she arrived back to America. So I thought, well, what could I do? And I went out and bought brand new house, brand new cars, brand new furniture, and spent, you know, an immense amount of my money and just went hog wild. And some of that racking up debt too, right? To go get my new Ukrainian wife. And, you know, she would have been surprised enough just the way things were before I did that. Now she arrives and there's this castle and there's this cars. What do I got left to surprise her with?
So guys, the fourth big fuck up when you get your beautiful Ukrainian wife back home, Jeff, is?
Make a baby right away. Uh-huh. Why do I have 5 kids? Well, because every approach that I had was, I'm looking for a family. So it made logical sense. I'm looking for a family. Why am I getting married? Well, I'm getting married because I want to have a kid, right? That jumped to that first thing. Oh my God. No chance to establish that relationship yet. No chance for her to adjust, for you to adjust. I sit there and go, what was I thinking? Because it creates a huge, huge set of problems that already make a difficult situation hard to overcome.
Well, I defer this point to you. You're obviously the expert on this point. So I imagine you just didn't have the time to really ground the relationship sufficiently.
Of course not.
Before the problem of a sleepless baby comes
and I fell into the trap certainly with my second relationship because she said from the onset, oh, I want to have family. I want to have 8 kids, she said. 8 kids. Ukrainian girl saying, I want 8 kids. She was young. Guess what? You know, after she had 1 kid, 8 went down to, hey, I'm happy with 1, you know. imagine how that happens. And because of that, I rushed right into it. I mean, we got pregnant literally the first month we got married. And there's no time to establish anything, much less acclimation. And you got a baby coming, and that's enough for most people, a trauma. So yeah, don't feel rushed to rush into it, because it will cause you too many problems, really.